Overnight, it has become the world's most famous hotel. The Trump National Doral, chosen as the site of the next G7 summit, is at the center of a national furor.
This is something we have literally never seen before, a president awarding a huge government contract to his own business.
He has bought himself an enormous headache now.
Thank goodness that they found a hotel with a golf course. You know how hard those are to find in the United States?
The Doral has 643 rooms in a cluster of bungalows and a world-class golf course called the Blue Monster. Here's what it's like inside the luxury suites where the world leaders will stay. Look, even the toiletries have Trump's name on them. CBS News travel editor Peter Greenberg has stayed at the resort many times.
They have different units there on the actual resort property, and each unit may have 20 to 30 different rooms. So what Trump is saying is that this lends itself well to different delegations from different countries because they each get their own building.
But the hotel is facing steep financial decline, according to the Washington Post. It has an occupancy rate of just 53%. Revenue dropped from $125 million in 2016 to $75 million last year. So, how's the food? We obtained the Florida State Health Inspection reports, which found 52 violations in 2017 and 2018, including a salad bar lacking adequate sneeze guards, food left out overnight, single-use gloves not changed when damaged or soiled. But this year, the resort cleaned up its act and had no high-priority violations. In 2016, a guest sued, claiming his room was infested with bed bugs. The case was settled out of court, and the president tweeted, "No bed bugs at Doral. False and nasty rumor." There will be massive security during the G7 summit. But last year, there was a serious breach when a deranged 42-year-old man, said to be obsessed with First Lady Melania Trump, fought a running gun battle with police in the lobby until he was taken down. The president tried to put the Trump National Doral controversy behind him today. With Ivanka at his side, he spoke to the two female astronauts during their historic spacewalk.
I'm here with my daughter Ivanka. We're thrilled to be speaking live with two brave American astronauts who are making history.